From Spoofing, how spammers send email that looks like it came from you. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I get from time to time. Okay, I know that spammers can send email spoofing the from address to make it look like it came from me, but how? How do they gain access to my account to do that? Have I been hacked? That last one is easy. No, you have not been hacked. They do not need access to your account. From spoofing means faking the from address on an email to make it look like it came from you. To do it, spammers don't need access to your account. I'd say that 99.99% of the time, it has nothing at all to do with your account or you. They only need your email address. While your email account and your email address are related, they're actually not the same thing. Let's clarify that. Your email account is what you use to log into and gain access to the email you've received. In most cases, it's also what you use to send email. Your email address allows the email system to route messages to your inbox. It's what you give other people, like I might give you, leo@askleo.com. The two are related only to the extent that email routed to you using your email address is placed into the inbox accessed by your email account. So to see how spammers get away with from spoofing, let's take a look at how you create an account in an email program. Using advanced or custom setup, we get a dialog asking for a variety of information. The pieces that matter, I'm going to focus on three. The email address. This is the email address that will be displayed on the from line in the emails you sent. Normally, you would want this to be your actual email address. But in reality, you can type in whatever you like. The username. This, with the password below it, is what identifies you to the mail service and grants you access to your mailbox for incoming mail and authorizes you to send mail. Your username might be your email address, but it doesn't have to be. Sending your message using this name. This is called the display name. You might find other terms for it in other email program configurations. This is the name that will be displayed on the from line in the emails you send. Normally, again, you would want this to be your own name, but in reality, you can type in whatever you like. Very often, email programs display email addresses using both the display name and the email address, with the email address in angle brackets. From, display name, and then in angle brackets, email address. This is used when most email programs create an email you're about to send, and that's what you'll see in the from line of those emails. From spoofing. To send an email appearing to be from someone else, all you need to do is to create an email account in your favorite email program using your own email account information while specifying someone else's email address and name. For example, here I've got an email address of santaclaus@northpole.com and a display name or send your message using this name of Santa Claus. I'm still logged into the same username account and I'm still connecting to the same mail service. Email address. Like we said, it could be whatever you like. santaclaus@northpole.com. Username. This with the password is what identifies you to the mail service and it grants you access to your mailbox for incoming mail and authorizes you to also send email. This hasn't changed. Send your emails using this name. Again, can be whatever you like, which is why I entered Santa Claus. Emails sent using this configuration would have a spoofed from address. From Santa Claus. And then santaclaus@northpole.com in angle brackets. And that, or its equivalent, is exactly what spammers do. Now, before you run off and start trying to spoof email from Santa Claus yourself, there are, of course, catches. Your email program might not support it. For example, most web-based email services don't have a way to specify a different email address to send from. Or if they do, they require you to confirm that you can access email that was sent to that address first. However, sometimes you can connect to those same services using a desktop email program like Microsoft Office Outlook, as I've shown above, and configure it to do so. Your email service might not support it. Some ISPs check the from address on outgoing mail to make sure that it hasn't been spoofed. Unfortunately, with the proliferation of custom domains, this approach is falling out of favor. For example, I might want to use the email account I have with my ISP to send email from my askleo.com email address. The ISP really has no way to know whether that's a legitimate thing or whether I'm a spammer spoofing that from line. It's probably not anonymous. You can set the from field to whatever you like, but you should be aware that other email headers, which you don't normally see, may still identify the account you used to log in when you sent the email. Even if it's not in the actual email headers, your ISP may very well have logs that indicate which account sent the email. And it might be illegal, depending on who you try to impersonate, your intent, and the laws in your jurisdiction. It's possible that misrepresenting yourself in email could run afoul of the law. Okay, so there's a whole list of reasons why it won't work. Spammers don't care. They use so-called botnets or zombies that act more like full-fledged mail servers than mail clients. They completely bypass the need to log in by attempting to deliver email directly to the recipient's email server. It's pretty close to anonymous because spam is exceedingly difficult to trace back to its origin. Okay, so after all this, you might be asking yourself, well, if they didn't compromise my account, where'd they get my email address? Spammers get email addresses everywhere. Data breaches, public postings, email forwarded by friends that don't remove your email address, less than reputable companies, some kinds of public forum postings, and more. Basically, spammers get your email address from wherever they can, but they don't need to access your account to spoof you. There's nothing special about the from address. Since it's just a setting on outgoing mail, seeing a particular from address doesn't imply any relationship to the actual account that would receive email sent to that address. Spammers don't need access to the account to make it appear in a from line. All they need to do is type it in the account settings, nothing more. That spam really did not come from that address at all. There's little to do other than mark spam as you get it, and don't rely on the from address at all. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3370. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.